first and some of the example from question second. At this lecture we are going to continue that part, and that is example fifth. The example fifth is cot cube of log of x raised to 3. Here consider y is equal to cot cube of log x raised to 3. Differentiate with respect to x. Therefore, dy by dx is equal to the term cot cube of x is there. Consider x is equal to log of x raised to 3. Whenever we sine square of theta, at that time we can be write as sine theta bracket raised to 2. In this example, cot cube of theta, at that time we can be write as cot theta for bracket raised to 3. That is cot cube of log of x raised to 3, it means cot of log x raised to 3 whole bracket raised to 3. So take the first of all derivative for this index, and that is 3 multiplied by index raised by 1, that is 3 into cot square of log of x raised to 3. Multiply by, we have to be take the derivative for cot of log x raised to 3. At next step, 3 into cot square of log x raised to 3 remains as it is, into derivative for cot. Here consider the value of x as log of x raised to 3, and we know that the derivative for cot x is minus cosec square of x, and that is minus cosec square of x we considered as x log of x raised to 3. Multiply by, again take the derivative for bracket term, it means derivative for log of x raised to 3 is equal to minus 3 into cot square of log x raised to 3 into cosec square of log x raised to 3 into derivative for log of x raised to 3 is 1 divided by x raised to 3. Multiply by, take the derivative for x raised to 3. Here derivative for log x is 1 divided by x. We can be considered the value of x is equal to x raised to 3. That is why the derivative for log x raised to 3 is 1 divided by x raised to 3 into take the derivative for x raised to 3. Now minus 3 into cot square of log x raised to 3 into cosec square of log x raised to 3 multiplied by 1 divided by x raised to 3 into derivative of x raised to 3 is 3 into x square. Therefore, as a dy by dx is equal to minus 3 r 9 into cot square of log x raised to 3 into cosec square of log x raised to 3 divided by, from here numerator and denominator x square get cancelled, that is why only one x remains in the denominator. Therefore dy by dx is equal to minus 9 into cot square of log x raised to 3 into cosec square of log x raised to 3 divided by x, and that is the derivative for the given function. So you can be right or take a screenshot. 5 raised to sin cube x plus 3. Let y is equal to 5 raised to sin cube x plus 3. Here the function is in form of a raised to x, where the value of x is whole function, and we know that derivative for a raised to x is a raised to x into log a. By using this formula we can differentiate to the given function. So differentiate with respect to x. Therefore dy by dx is equal to, by using formula we can write as 5 raised to sin cube x plus 3 as it is into log of 5 into, we have to be differentiate the given function which is in form of index, that is sin cube x plus 3. At next step, this term remains as it is. 5 raised to sine cube x plus 3 into log of 5 into derivative of the bracket. In bracket, there are two terms. Take the separate derivative to each one. That is, derivative for sine cube x plus derivative for 3. That is equal to 5 raised to sine cube x plus 3 into log of 5 as it is. Into derivative of sine cube x is 3 into sine square x. Again, we have to take the derivative for this sine, that is derivative for sine x, plus derivative for the 3. Here 3 is a constant term, its derivative is 0. That is why dy by dx is equal to 5 raised to sine cube x plus 3 into log of 5 into in bracket 3 into sine square of x multiplied by derivative for sine x is cos x plus 0, that as it is. Therefore, the final answer as derivative of y with respect to x is equal to 3 into sine square x into cos x multiplied by 5 raised to sine cube x plus 3 multiplied by log of 5. And that is the final answer. It means derivative for the given function. So, write down. Next example is cosec of root cos x. Let y is equal to cosec of square root of cos x. Here function of a function is present. Differentiate with respect to x. Therefore, dy by dx is equal to, first of all, take the derivative for cosec and then take the derivative for that bracket function. So, the derivative for cosec x is minus cot x into cosec x. That is why minus cot of square root of cos x into cosec of square root of cos x. Again, we have to take the derivative for bracket term, and that is square root of cos x. So dy by dx is equal to minus cot of square root of cos x into cosec of square root of cos x multiplied by derivative of root cos x is there. And we know that formula for derivative for root x is 1 divided by 2 root x. Here we can consider the term x as cos x. So its derivative is 1 divided by 2 into square root of cos x into, again we have to take the derivative for cos x. That is why minus cot of square root of cos x into cosec of square root of cos x divided by 2 into square root of cos x multiplied by derivative of cos x is minus sin x. So, the final answer as the derivative of y with respect to x is equal to minus into minus with plus, and that is sine x into cot of square root of cos x into cosec of square root of cos x whole divided by 2 into root of cos x. So, that is the final answer for the given question. It means derivative of the function cosec of square root of cos x. So you can write down or you can take a screenshot also. Example is log of cos of x cube minus 5. Let y is equal to log of cos x raised to 3 minus 5. Y is equal to log of cos of x cube minus 5. Differentiate with respect to x. That is why dy by dx is equal to, first of all, take the derivative for log, and that is log x. The derivative for log x with respect to x is 1 divided by x. By using this formula, we can write its derivative. Here the value of x we can be considered as cos of x cube minus 5. So, its derivative is 1 divided by cos of x raised to 3 minus 5. Into, again take the derivative for a bracket, that is cos of x cube minus 5. So 1 divided by cos of x cube minus 5 into derivative of cos x is minus sin x, and that is minus sin. The value of x we can be considered as x cube minus 5, therefore its derivative is minus sin x cube minus 5. Again, we have to take the derivative for the bracket, and that bracket term is x cube minus 5. So, minus sin x cube minus 5 divided by cos of x cube minus 5 multiplied by derivative of the bracket. In bracket there are two terms in subtraction form. So, derivative for first one is 3 into x square minus derivative of 5, which is a constant term, and its derivative is 0. And we know that sin theta by cos theta is equal to tan theta. Here the value of theta is x cube minus 5. So sin of x cube minus 5 divided by cos of x cube minus 5 we can be write as tan of x cube minus 5 into, in bracket term, 3 into x square. So the final answer as dy by dx is equal to minus 3x square into tan of x cube minus 5, and that is the final answer in its derivative for the given function log of cos of x cube minus 5. So you can be write down or take a screenshot. Ninth example is e raised to 3 into sin square x minus 2 into cos square of x. Here the function is in form of e raised to x, and we know that derivative for e raised to x is e raised to x. Here let y is equal to e raised to 3 into sin square x minus 2 into cos square of x is there. So differentiate with respect to x. That is why dy by dx is equal to e raised to x has the given function in form of a e raised to x, and its derivative is e raised to x. Here consider the value of x is 3 into sin square x minus 2 into cos square of x. So its derivative is e raised to 3 sin square x minus 2 into cos square of x as it is, into, we have to be take the derivative for the function, it means derivative for 3 into sin square x minus 2 into cos square of x. So this term remains as it is at next step, that is e raised to 3 sin square x minus 2 into cos square of x into derivative for the bracket. In bracket there are two terms which are in subtraction form. So here we have to be take the derivative for each one. So derivative for 3 into sin square x minus derivative for 2 into cos square of x. So at next step, e raised to 3 sin square x minus 2 into cos square of x into, in bracket 3 is in a multiplication form to the function. So take it out of a derivative, and again take the derivative for sin square of x. Minus 2 is also constant term which is in multiplication form to the function, that is why take it also out of the derivative. 2 into derivative of the function, that is cos square of x. E raised to 3 sin square x minus 2 cos square of x as it is into 3 multiplied by derivative for sin square x is 2 into sin x multiplied by, take the derivative for sin, and that is cos x. Minus 2 multiplied by derivative of cos square x is, that is 2 is index form, take it out of multiplication form to the cos, that is 2 multiplied by cos x. Again we have to be take the derivative for cos, and its derivative is minus sin x. So e raised to 3 into sin square x minus 2 into cos square x, in bracket 6 sin x into cos x, minus into minus get plus, 2 are 4 into sin x into cos x. So at next step, as dy by dx is equal to, we can split to the 10 as 5 multiplied by 2. That is what? Dy by dx is equal to e raised to 3 sin square x minus 2 cos square of x into 5 multiplied by 2 into sin x into cos x. Here 2 into sin x into cos x we can write as sin 2x by using this formula, and that is 2 into sin theta into cos theta is equal to sin of 2 theta. Therefore, our final answer as dy by dx is equal to 5 multiplied by, for this term we can write as sin 2x multiplied by e raised to 3 into sin square x minus 2 into cos square of x, and that is our final answer. It means derivative for the given function. So write down. Next example is cos square of log x square plus 7. Let y is equal to cos square of log of x square plus 7. Differentiate with respect to x. Here cos square of a function is there. So take the derivative for that index. It means dy by dx is equal to 2 into cos of log x square plus 7 into, take the derivative for cos, that is cos of function, cos of log of x square plus 7, and next step 2 into cos of log of x square plus 7 multiplied by derivative for the cos x. Here we can take as a value or consider the value of x as log of x square plus 7. So the derivative for cos is minus sin x, that is why minus sin of log of x square plus 7 into, take the derivative for the bracket, that is derivative for log of x square plus 7 is equal to minus 2 into sine of log of x square plus 7 into cos of log of x square plus 7 into derivative for log x is, here consider the value of x is sin x square plus 7. Therefore, the derivative for log x is 1 by x, that is why derivative for log of x square plus 7 is 1 divided by x square plus 7 into derivative for x square plus 7. That is why, and we know that formula for 2 into sin theta into cos theta, it has formula sin 2 theta. Here the term is present in this form as theta is, can be considered as log of x square plus 7, that is minus 2 into sin of log x square plus 7 into cos of log x square plus 7 is present. It means the value of theta we can be considered as log of x square plus 7, which one be here. That is why its answer we can be write minus as it is 2 sin theta into cos theta is equal to sin 2 theta. That is why we can be write as sin of 2 of log of x square plus 7 into 1 divided by x square plus 7, again multiply by derivative for the bracket term. Derivative for x square is 2x plus derivative for 7, which is 0. So the final answer as dy by dx is equal to minus 2x into sin of 2 of log of x square plus 7 divided by x square plus 7, and that is the final answer. It is derivative for the given function. Next example is tan of cos of sin x. Let y is equal to tan of cos of sin x. Differentiate with respect to x. So dy by dx is equal to here function of function of function is there. So take the derivative for tan x. Here the value of x can be considered as cos of sin x. So the derivative of tan x is sec square of x. That is what? Sec square of cos of sin x into, take the derivative for cos of sin x. So next step is sec square of cos of sin x into derivative for cos x. Here again we can be considered as the value of x is sin x. So the derivative for sin cos x is minus sin x. So its derivative is minus sin of sin x into derivative for sin x. That is what? Minus sin of sin x into sec square of cos of sin x into derivative for sin x is cos x. So the final answer as a dy by dx is equal to minus cos x into sin of sin x into sec square of cos of sin x. And that is the final answer, it means derivative for the given function tan of cos of sin x. So write down. Now the next example is sec of tan of x raised to 4 plus 4. Here consider y is equal to sec of tan of x raised to 4 plus 4. Differentiate with respect to x. That is what? Derivative of y with respect to x is equal to function of function of function is there. So take the derivative for first one, that is derivative for sec x. And we know that the derivative for sec x is sec x into tan x. Here the value of x we can be considered as tan of x raised to 4 plus 4. So its derivative is sec of tan of x raised to 4 plus 4 into tan x raised to 4 plus 4. That is the derivative for sec x. Sec x into tan x, the value of x we considered as tan of x square plus 4. So its derivative is sec of tan of x raised to 4 plus 4 into tan of x raised to 4 plus 4. Into again we have to be take the derivative for bracket, it means derivative for tan of x raised to 4 plus 4. At next step this remains as it is, sec of tan x raised to 4 plus 4 into tan x raised to 4 plus 4 into derivative for tan x. We know that derivative of tan x is sec square of x, but here we can be considered value of x is x raised to 4 plus 4. We can be considered that one. So its derivative is sec square of x raised to 4 plus 4. Again, take the derivative for the bracket, that is derivative for x raised to 4 plus 4. Here this term remains as it is, that is why sec of tan x raised to 4 plus 4 into tan x raised to 4 plus 4 into sec square of x raised to 4 plus 4 multiplied by derivative of x raised to 4 is 4 into x raised to 3 plus derivative of 4 is, which is a constant now and its derivative is 0. Therefore the derivative of 4 is 0. That is why its final answer as dy by dx is equal to 4 into x raised to 3 into sec of tan of x raised to 4 plus 4 into tan x raised to 4 plus 4 multiplied by, that is sec square of x raised to 4 plus 4. And that is the final answer for the given example or for that is the derivative for the given function. So you can be write down or you can take a screenshot for this answer to that answer. At this lecture we solve some examples from the question second. At next lecture we shall continue this part.